So I'm here in the land that was to be the remainder of Marriott's Harbor Lake here in Orlando, Florida. And I want to talk about something, and that just happens to be, will Marriott Vacation Club ever build another timeshare property in Orlando? Let's talk about it right after this. Hello and welcome to Destination Timeshare. I'm Jeremy, and before we start talking about this situation where I'm actually wondering, will Marriott Vacation Club and even Sheraton, which is also owned by Marriott Vacations Worldwide, Sheraton Vacation Club, ever build another timeshare property in Orlando? I want to let you know, on this channel, I provide my knowledge, tips, and advice to help you get the most from your timeshare ownership. So if that's the kind of stuff you want to see, be sure to hit subscribe down below. Also, click on that notification bell and select all, and you'll be notified whenever I post new videos. Okay, so let's talk about this. Marriott Vacations Worldwide recently has actually been selling off a number of parcels of land for resorts where they had actually originally planned to build a lot more units, a lot more villas, and Marriott's Harbor Lake here is one of them. You can actually see behind me the overgrown, weed-infested parking lot here that was supposed to be among a number of other buildings here, a total of 900 villas in total, and they just never finished it. And at one time, they actually announced a land sale where they were going to sell this land to a developer who would essentially come in and most likely put in apartment homes and that type of thing, maybe even some other hotels. That sale fell through. I did do a video about that, and if you want to see that video, I will put a link right up here. But that also kind of leads me to think, are they ever going to build another resort in Orlando? Because even down at Sheraton Vistana Villages, they had another entire phase planned, and they actually recently announced a sale of that to a Georgia developer who's going to come in and put in apartment homes. Another link up here about that in a video I did as well. So, talking about this and thinking this through, when Marriott Vacation Club converted to their Destinations Club points program back in 2010, they actually created a land trust, real estate land trust, and deposited all of their leftover units at the time. And since then, any new units, new resorts that they've built out, they've been putting in that trust. So places like South Beach, a whole bunch of units were actually put in there, and the entire new towers of Crystal Shores were put into that land trust. All the properties across the United States pretty much all have units in that land trust. There are a few exceptions. Custom House in Boston is one of them. But yeah, Orlando, they've actually been actively trying to sell off land here. If you're wondering why it's so much noise here, I-4 is right behind me. So that kind of leads me to start wondering, when you think about the properties here in Orlando, when you're looking at the point costs in the Destinations Club points program, and you're looking at Orlando, when you compare Orlando to a lot of other places, the points costs are quite low, and that is obviously because Orlando has a lot of timeshare supply, a lot of competition with hotels in general as well. Some of them condo hotels that offer one bedroom, two bedroom, and three bedroom suites. This is pretty much the timeshare capital of the world. And that means obviously that what they can sell a timeshare for here is a lot lower. So they're obviously assigning a lot lower point values to these properties. So that makes you think, if the building costs and marketing costs are about similar here as it would be in places like California, the Caribbean, Hawaii. Obviously, building costs are going to be a little bit higher in those kinds of places. It just makes you wonder, though, they are assigning much higher point values to those properties because the demand is so much higher there, because there are far fewer timeshare resorts in places like Hawaii, in the Caribbean, and they just don't seem to want to build new resorts here in Orlando. So I'm kind of wondering, are they ever going to build any new ones? Because they've actively been selling off land The only land that I know that they aren't actively trying to market is the remaining undeveloped land at Lakeshore Reserve, and they may not be able to sell that because it's kind of landlocked and part of the larger Grand Lakes development. I'm not sure if the hotel and the larger development there would like apartments built there in Grand Lakes. So one thing I think they need to start doing, instead of trying to sell this land, the timeshare companies in Orlando need to innovate a lot like Disney Vacation Club has. You can build different style villas and units that you can charge more points for. If you consider Disney Vacation Club, they have the treehouse villas. They have the over-the-water bungalows at the Polynesian, and they also have the cabins at Copper Creek. Definitely a point premium on those, and a much different style of villa than the cookie-cutter two-bedroom and two-bedroom lock-offs that most of these resorts seem to have. So why don't they just innovate? You don't need to be building cookie-cutter one, two, and three-bedroom villas in Orlando. Take the route of Disney Vacation Club, build treehouse villas, build over-the-water bungalows. Over at Cypress Harbor, where they actually sold off the golf course, they could have put two or three small over-water bungalows over the lake there. Yes, it does cost more, but it gives people a unique vacation experience if they're willing to pay the extra points, and you get a bigger return on the investment because you can charge a points premium for that different type of experience that people will definitely probably want to take advantage of. So that's just my thoughts on if they will ever build another timeshare in Orlando, and really why I think they should. They just need to get out of the 1990s and the 2000s and think of how the new modern traveler, even the younger traveler, those very famous people we always hear of, the millennials, want to travel and give us some different kind of vacation timeshare experiences, some different style of villas than they're used to churning out. So what are your thoughts on this? Do you think Marriott Vacation Club, Sheraton Vacation Club will ever build another timeshare property or even additional units in Orlando? And also, what are your thoughts on these different types of villas, these different types of units? Would you stay in a treehouse villa, an over-the-water bungalow, or even an interesting cabin like Disney Vacation Club has created in their timeshare system? Let me know all about it. Definitely want to hear your thoughts down in the comments below. And if you like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. And to see more videos about timeshare, check out the description box below. For another video about Marriott Vacation Club, check out this one right up here and YouTube. They think you'll like that one down there. Be sure to subscribe. You can do so by clicking on my picture right here. Hit that notification bell. And until next time, let's make your next destination a timeshare.